viewer discretion is advised.
It was a full moon. The woman immediately fell to the ground in front of a lake and began wailing in pain as her husband helped her to deliver her child. A wondrous occasion. The man was overjoyed as he lifted his crying child up into the air, bathing the infant in the moonlight. But the moment was short-lived. The man then let go of his hold. Soon after, his child plunged into the water. Something emerged from the water. The child's head rose above the waves and skinned itself as its flesh reorganized itself to that of a goat with devilish horns created from its own skull. It shrieked in pain as its body reshaped itself into a bipedal monstrosity similar to that of a satyr. Finally, a pair of fleshy and bloody wings erupted from its back, crafted from its own body. Giving a final gurgling shriek, it flew at its parents with tremendous speed. With hooked hands and reckless abandon, it tore its mother to pieces, devouring her flesh as it did so. The father was unfazed. He only stood and watched. "Praise Ian!" the father screamed in delirium and knelt next to their demonic offspring. But the beast paid that sentiment no mind and sliced its father's head off. The beast was bathed in its parents' blood. It let out a loud shriek that echoed through the night. Hello everybody, I'm The Rubber. Today, we bring you a SCP Foundation Euclid class object, SCP-4059. SCP-4059, also known as the Jersey Devil, refers to a collection of anomalies within the Pinelands National Reserve in New Jersey, USA. There are three main anomalies that reside in this area. SCP-4059-1 is a small pond around 90 feet in length that is surrounded by cabins built during the 1850s by Polish settlers. Near the water, however, dozens of skeletal remains of human infants were found, but with an array of physical deformities, indicating they died shortly after birth, most likely by their own afflictions and not by the hands of their parents. This area has no anomalous capabilities unless two individuals perform a ritual known as Procedure 4059 Chemosh. The second anomaly is SCP-4059-2. These creatures are goat-like in appearance, but are bipedal in nature, with bat-like wings, horns, and hooked claws. Their most distinct marker is their forked tail, and has earned this anomaly the moniker of the Jersey Devil by the locals. 4059-2 are adept predators. It stalks its prey and will incapacitate them with a bite to the throat. Instances have been reported to be able to move at speeds upwards of 90 kilometers per hour for brief periods of time in the pursuit of prey. Instances of 4059-2 typically avoid human contact, but can become aggressive when trapped or provoked, and they have been known to stalk and kill humans. At seemingly random intervals, 4059-2 may return to 4059-1 to drink. Lastly, SCP-4059-3 is the journal written by a Polish settler that includes the details about the founding and daily life as a resident of 4059-1, as well as the proper execution of Procedure 4059 Chemosh, in which instances of 4059-2 would be produced in a series of ritualistic rites. The journal details the exile of a group of Polish settlers and horror the writer discovered when they tried to grow their new community. In 1894, a group of Polish immigrants was exiled, and the land they had arrived at was not one of prosperity, as they had been led to believe. The soil was next to useless. Nothing would grow in the harsh clay of the forests, nor in the dry sand of the beaches. All they could do to survive was hunt, fish, and trade with a nearby town for sustenance. They feared the doom of the continuity of their lineage. One day, the man was asked if he remembers the tales of the Holy Flesh Weavers, how the elders have talked about their ability to bend muscle and bones to their very whim through fleshcraft. It gave him an idea. Perhaps, he thought, they could use the sacred site to lift its curse and purify their lineage with a sculpted progeny. And so a ritual was performed according to a few texts they took with them when they were exiled. It started on a full moon and ended with an auspicious gift. The women of the community soon bore children. The children were born, and to their horror, it became clear that there was much work to be done. They were not born as healthy as the people thought they would be. Rather, they were broken and twisted husks. The newborn died before taking a single breath, and so they were left with nothing. Yet the people persisted. For the next 12 years, they would refine the ritual, and eventually they arrived at the final iteration in 1908. The sacrament was successful, and it was their reckoning. Their joy quickly morphed into horror as the children emerged from the water as beasts who did not recognize their own kin. Their bodies stretched and twisted as they grew unnatural features. The skin of their backs tore open as wings grew out of it, and horns pierced through their forehead. Their faces stretched into goats, and their nails curved into deadly talons. Each one let out a horrific shriek as they stretched out for the first time. The people were frozen in shock. The beasts, which were once their children, slaughtered their very own mothers with ravenous fury. And when they were done with them, they turned to their fathers. The man ran from his home, ran from his wife, ran from his monstrous child. He ran from the sound of tearing flesh and screaming demons. Fast forward a century later, 4059 had been adequately secured and contained by the foundation. A new researcher was placed in charge of the site after the previous one met their end by an instance of 4059-2. The new researcher, Dr. Levy, was intensely interested in the journal of Japhet Bartosiewicz and the Sarkist lore and references held within it. He would spend days reading the text, claiming that if they were to defeat those vile, disease-ridden, blood-worshipping freaks, then they must learn all they can. With that said, everyone brushed him off as eccentric and left him to his own devices, the beginning of another downfall. Unbeknownst to everyone at the site, Dr. Levy had become infatuated with Sarkicism to an unhealthy degree, and soon sought out the aid of Sarkists to engage in a plan to revive them to full power once again. In order to do this, Dr. Levy enlisted a small army of Sarkists after he stole a sample of the disease SCP-610, the flesh that hates, which was a contagious skin disease anomaly, by using his high level of authorization. Convinced by this act, the Sarkists rallied behind the doctor and raided the site on which 4059 stood. They quickly overran all researchers and security personnel on site. In line with their ways, they murdered all they came across before they made it to 4059. With no one standing in his way, Dr. Levy took out the sample of 610, injected it into his body, and transformed into a grotesque abomination. His next stage of the plan was to engage in a ritual using procedure Chemosh and create a monstrous entity, a new breed of soldier, in order to help usher in the Sarkist takeover. Fortunately for the Foundation, the incident was reported to the O5 Council members, and SCP-076-2, Abel, was dispatched with MTF cabin fever to eradicate the threat. Regretfully, the number of soldiers sent was quickly outmatched by the superior number of Sarkists that were waiting for them and were brutally slaughtered, except for an agent who was protected by Abel. The duo, with the aid of Abel's divine abilities, managed to kill every Sarkist in the vicinity. Upon seeing Dr. Levy, Abel became extremely enraged. "I will not allow the spawn of the God Eater to be reborn." In one swing, Abel sliced Dr. Levy into pieces as he pleaded for mercy. Once its bloodlust was satiated, it told the agent to burn the body thoroughly, as well as all of the Sarkists that were slain. "I've seen what these bastards have done. Never again. Never again," Abel said, looking off into space. The agent made the call, and MTF creepy crawlies were then pulled from their site in order to burn the bodies as Abel instructed. It was then determined that the journal was to be locked away and under guard 24/7. No one was made aware of Procedure Chemosh after that day. Having been made aware that the Sarkists may now have an interest in 4059, security was beefed up in the area in order to respond to any large-scale attacks. No similar incident has occurred since Incident 4059, but the O5 Council has expressed an interest in learning of any changes regarding anything on site. In a rare occurrence of teamwork, the Foundation informed the Church of the Broken God and the Global Occult Coalition of the event and informed them to be on guard against the Sarkists. As for instances 4059-2, they became skittish and unusually meek the following 2 weeks after the incident. It is hypothesized that they were experiencing an instinctive fear due to 610 being introduced into the area and were afraid of running into it. Once the dust had settled on the event, everything within 4059 went back to as normal as it could possibly be, with the 05 Council sighing a breath of relief at avoiding a possible K-Class scenario event. Remember to check out my new animation channel, The Rubber Talks, where I share my life story, thoughts, and opinions. Just click on the link in the description to enter the Rubber's world. Before we end this video, we are proud to present these incredibly sweet pieces of fan art. A big thank you to all of you. You can now send us your fan art, and we will be more than happy to show off your best art piece in our next video. Check out our description below on how to submit. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Which SCP do you want to see in the next video and why it is interesting? Let us know in the comment below. We will draw your story and share it with the world. Don't forget to click like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell. Please share it to your friends if you like this video. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.